Hey, I'm Dan Brown here at PAX East in Boston 2012 with Jonathan Coulton. And first question, for those who don't know who are you? What do you do?
It's a great question. Great question. I'm a singer-songwriter, probably most famous for writing songs from the video games Portal.
And what do you get out of coming to events like PAX?
It's just one of those conventions where it's like you're there and it's actually about the fans. It's not about the trade aspects of it or the, you know, it's a really nice bunch of people.
We have to talk about it. Portal.
Yes.
I love Portal. Like, I really love Portal.
I do too. It's a great game.
Still Alive, it was the perfect ending to the perfect game. So just tell that story. How did that come about?
I was doing a show in Seattle.
Okay.
And somebody came up to me after the show and introduced themselves, and it was Kim Swift, who was the project lead for Portal. And she said, would you ever want to write music for video games? And I said, yeah, sure, you know. And so they brought me to the offices, and we... I got to play through an early version of Portal before it was done, which was awesome because I had seen the teaser trailer online and I was really excited about it. And then we talked about a few different options, but we ended up deciding to do a song for Portal. It seemed like a good challenge, and GLaDOS was such a fantastic character that it was easy to write a song for her to sing.
Well, I was going
to
say, is it much of a departure for you to write as an evil, demented supercomputer?
No, I mean, truth be told, it's kind of the song that I keep writing over and over again anyway. So, but yeah, it was a character. I mean, really, the credit goes to Val for drawing such a strong, clear character that it was easy for me to find her voice, you know?
So last year on NPR, you revealed that you make a good chunk of change from your music. I think you said $500,000 a year.
Yeah, that was my gross in the year 2010 or 9 or something.
I mean, that's great. That's without a label.
Yeah.
Do you think that that's an anomaly just because of where, like, the who you appeal to with your music, or do you think that you kind of represent a model for the future?
I think that it's a little bit of both. I think that I certainly have been helped a great deal by the fact that the songs I do some of them are comedic in nature, they appeal to nerds, they sort of tap into a zeitgeist that's happening now. But I also think that, you know, what I'm doing is not that much different from what even signed label artists are doing. In many ways, it's the border between signed and unsigned is shrinking. It's not as big a distinction as it once was.
Would you say you came into prominence through your Thingawik project in 2005, 2006?
Yeah, that was definitely the rise to power, yeah.
And what was Thingawik?
Well, in 2005, I left my day job writing software to pursue music full time. And every week on Friday, I would publish a new song that I had recorded that week. And I did that for a year. And over the course of that year, I had a few songs that kind of had a viral thing happen. And by the end of that year, I was able to do shows in cities where I didn't live. And people would come to them and buy tickets. And so, yeah, that was the beginning of it all, for sure.
Was there any one specific breakout moment where you're kind of like, oh, this is working?
Oh, there were a few. I think it was song number 5 was the cover of Baby Got Back, the Sir Mix-a-Lot song that I did. That just went crazy overnight.
You mentioned a little bit that it got to be a little taxing. Was there ever a point where you're just like, what have I gotten myself into? Why am I still doing that?
Oh, yeah, every week. I mean, I actually went back. It was the 5-year anniversary of Thingawik, and I actually went back and sort of reblogged it 5 years later. And I had forgotten what pits of despair I fell into. The whole enterprise of quitting my job and putting songs on the internet felt like a very vain and stupid thing to do a lot of the time. So when I would have a success, I'd be like, yes, it's working. And then that success, as it does on the internet, immediately goes away. And then you're left with nothing. And it was really hard to keep going. And so there were times when I was like, I can't do this anymore. But I'm glad I did, because that was when it got interesting. Like, when I was out, completely out of juice, and had no ideas, that's when I wrote some of my favorite songs of my songwriting career.